Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This episode is part 2 of a 2-part series that covers issues you may encounter when working with After Effects, Illustrator, and Photoshop. If you haven't seen the previous episode, I highly recommend you do that now. It's not necessary for you to understand the concepts we'll be covering, but it will give you a much broader understanding of how these three apps work together. In this episode, we're going to go over how to export layers out of After Effects to be opened and used in Illustrator or Photoshop. We're also going to cover issues you may encounter when working with text layers between these three apps. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Usually, you will design something either directly in After Effects, or you may design it in Photoshop or Illustrator and bring it into After Effects. So the crux of this episode is something that I came across recently with one of my own clients. I had created everything in After Effects, and then my client said he wanted to use my images for print, so they needed the vectorized versions of this. Even though shape layers are automatically vectorized, I can't really export this in a way from After Effects that's going to maintain that vector quality. So going from Illustrator to After Effects, now I'm going from After Effects to Illustrator. The first thing you need to know is that track mats are not recognized, meaning like this Luma mat, this Alpha mat, those will not be recognized. And I'll show you what I'm talking about. So let's go to composition, and you always want to go save frame as Photoshop layers. Do not use save frame as file. So let's hit save, and you'll get a warning here. You'll see the warning says, this composition contains track mats or blending modes which are not available in Photoshop. So again, whenever you're going from After Effects to Illustrator or Photoshop, Illustrator and Photoshop will not recognize track mats or blending modes coming out of After Effects. But there is a workaround, and I'll get to that in just a second. So let's go over to our Photoshop, and then let's open up that file. So it's this right here. You'll notice whenever we open it up, that track mat was not recognized. And so you can see it around the text and around our guy here. So over here, our guy is constrained within this circle over here. He comes off. And then we have this Luma mat over this shape layer here. And as you can see, it's just a mess here. Okay, so now how do we get around that? Well, let's close that out. And I'm going to show you a really quick trick. If we go back into After Effects, what you want to do is pre-comp anything that has Luma mats or blending modes. Here's our Luma mat right here. It's basically these two layers right here. So we're going to pre-compose that, and we're going to call this Luma layer. The other issue is this Alpha mat here. And see, if we take this Alpha mat off, we can see that it's basically, that's the thing that's keeping the guy inside the circle. The way to get around Alpha mats is to use a set mat. So we'll go up to our effects and presets, set mat, and then we want to set this to the circle layer above it, and make sure you take off this alpha, and I'll make this no track mat. So see, this set mat is going to be what's going to make our man stay within the circle. And this Luma layer, now that it's pre-comped, let's go inside of here. There are a few steps we need to do. So let's go to composition, save frame as, and this time you want to choose file. So the only time you want to choose save frame as file is whenever you're doing a Luma mat or blending mode pre-comp. So let's choose that. Change from JPEG, let's make that a PNG sequence. Make sure you have RGB plus alpha chosen. Hit OK. And then let's go down here to our output module. There's this thing called post render action. So let's choose import and replace usage. So this is basically going to replace our pre-comp with this new image here. So we'll choose that and hit render. Let's go back into our main comp here. And as we can see, this PNG has now replaced that pre-comp. And as you can see, we still have the pre-comp. It's just in this comp right here, it has been replaced by this PNG. And so now when we go to composition, save frame as, and remember, always choose save frame as Photoshop layers whenever you're doing your final export. We'll choose that and we'll overwrite this, go back into Photoshop, and then let's open that back up. And as we can see now, our guy stays within a circle, and this Luma mat issue has now been resolved because it rendered out the PNG instead of the pre-comp for that layer. And we can even check out our layers over here. So see this Luma mat, as you can see, it came in as the PNG. Okay, so now let's open back up Illustrator, and you can actually pull in Photoshop files into Illustrator. So if we bring that in, the first thing you'll see is this show preview option. Make sure that's clicked. And you always want to choose convert layers to objects. Click OK. This is what it looks like in Illustrator if you bring in a Photoshop file that you exported out of After Effects. My client only needed this image. He didn't need the text. So I'm actually going to just get rid of all this other information here. You can drag it down this garbage can right there. And now we can grab everything in here, center this up. Our artboard right here is 1920 by 1080. Let me zoom out a little bit. And let's actually just make our artboard a lot bigger. So we'll just increase it crazy big and grab this selection tool here. We're just going to increase it. And as you can see, no matter how big we make it, it still retains its clarity. Make sure the artboard extends around everything. The thing that you'll notice is if you open up these layers here, these are just all solid images. So now this was the Illustrator file that we brought in. And as you can see, we can convert these to shape layers and get all of this information here. Well, the thing to keep in mind is when you go in the opposite direction, meaning when you come out of After Effects into Illustrator, you don't get quite as much information. Let me just go ahead and open that original back up. When it show preview and convert layers to objects, if you open that back up, our text layers here, they're not really text layers, they're images. And you can even see it says here, dealing with image. You open that up, this is an image. There's no way to convert this to a text layer. Whenever you're exporting a shape layer or a comp from After Effects to be used in Illustrator, once it gets to Illustrator, these text layers are just going to be images. They're not going to be actual text layers. And it's the same way in Photoshop. Whenever you're exporting out of After Effects, any text layer is just going to come through as an image. It is not going to be an editable text layer. So say like we take this dealing with, if we open up our properties, we can see there's no font. Very important thing to remember, whenever you're exporting out of After Effects, like a shape layer, text layer, to be used in Photoshop or Illustrator, they're going to come out only as images. So just to quickly recap, when going from After Effects to Illustrator or Photoshop, remember you must replace your alpha mats with set mat. You also want to make sure that you pre-comp layers that are affected by luma mats and or blending modes. This is the one time you want to use composition, save frame as file, then you want to render it as a PNG, making sure that RGB plus alpha is selected, and set your post-render action to import and replace usage. Your final export should always be under composition, save frame as Photoshop layers. Make sure you're not using save frame as file. Only use file when pre-rendering layers that use luma mats and or blending modes. When bringing in Photoshop files that were exported out of After Effects into Illustrator, make sure you have show preview selected as well as convert layers to objects. Remember, text layers exported out of After Effects and opened in Illustrator or Photoshop will not be editable. Text is only editable when it is exported out of Photoshop or as a PSD file out of Illustrator and brought into After Effects. Text editability does not go both ways. In addition, shape layers exported out of After Effects do not have the same level of editability once brought into Illustrator, but you can export them as vector images out of Illustrator. I hope that helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new episode. I'd love to get your feedback about this topic and also hear about any other topic you would like to see covered. Don't forget to check out my new Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers. The link to that course, as well as the notes for this episode, are in the description below. And if you haven't already done so, make sure you check out the previous episode and learn how to export layers from Illustrator to After Effects for purposes of animation. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time. We'll be right back.